I'm just saying, you don't have to be so uptight. Camila's voice was casual, but there was an edge to it. She leaned back in her kitchen chair, eyes on her glass of wine as she swirled the dark liquid lazily. Hudson stood by the kitchen counter, arms crossed. His eyes never left her. "I'm not being uptight," he said, but his voice was strained. "It's just strange that you didn't mention it earlier." Camila rolled her eyes, a smirk tugging at the corner of her lips. "Relax, Hudson. You're always so suspicious. I'm going with my besties." "It's nothing." Hudson's eyes narrowed. The way she smiled, it didn't reach her eyes. It wasn't the smile he had fallen in love with all those years ago. It was dismissive, like he was just being unreasonable, like he was the one at fault for questioning her. He didn't respond immediately, just stood there watching her. A cold silence filled the room, and the sound of the clock ticking on the wall felt louder than it should. "You didn't tell me about this trip until last night," Hudson finally said, his voice quieter now, but firmer. Camila sighed dramatically and leaned forward, setting her wine glass on the table. "Hudson, for God's sake, it's just a weekend. Me and my friends are going to the lake. It's no big deal. You're making it one." "I'm not making a big deal," he shot back. "It just seems odd. You've been taking a lot of these trips lately." She rolled her eyes again and stood up, walking toward him. "Oh, come on. Don't start this again. What are you accusing me of? Cheating on you?" Her tone was mocking, as if the idea were so absurd it didn't even deserve a real response. Hudson felt his hands ball into fists at his sides, the tension in his body rising. He wanted to believe her. He wanted to believe that she was just going on a normal weekend getaway with her friend. But there were too many things that didn't add up anymore, too many late nights, too many phone calls she quickly silenced when he walked into the room. "I'm not accusing you of anything," he said, though his tone didn't match his words. He was accusing her, but he didn't know how to say it outright. "Not yet." Camila tilted her head, studying him for a moment. "Then why are we even having this conversation?" She laughed softly, shaking her head as she picked up her wine glass again. "You know, sometimes you can be so paranoid." "Maybe I wouldn't be paranoid if you were just a little more open with me," Hudson replied, his frustration bubbling up. "If you didn't keep things from me." "What am I keeping from you?" she asked, incredulous. "I told you where I'm going. I told you who I'm going with. What more do you want?" Hudson opened his mouth to respond, but the words stuck in his throat. What did he want? He wanted his wife back, the woman who used to laugh with him over the smallest things, who used to share everything with him, the woman who didn't make him feel like he was on the outside of his own marriage. But this wasn't her anymore. Camila's phone buzzed on the table. She glanced at it, her eyes flickering for just a second, but Hudson caught it. It was brief, but it was there, that quick, nervous look. She turned the phone over, screen side down, and took another sip of her wine, not saying anything. "What was that?" Hudson asked, his voice quieter now. "What was what?" Camila replied, her tone breezy, but she didn't meet his eyes. "The phone. You looked at it like what, Hudson?" She cut him off, her tone sharpening. "Like I was hiding something? Is that what you think?" "I don't know what to think anymore, Camila." The silence that followed was thick, heavy. Hudson could feel his pulse in his temples, his frustration and suspicion swirling inside him. She was hiding something. He knew it, but how could he prove it? He didn't want to believe it, didn't want to be the guy who doubted his wife. But every day, the doubt grew. Camila set her glass down a little too hard this time. "You're ridiculous, you know that. Just because I'm going away for the weekend doesn't mean I'm doing anything wrong. Then why are you acting so defensive?" Hudson countered, his voice rising. "Why do you always have an excuse?" "Because you won't let it go," she snapped, stepping closer to him. "God, Hudson, not everything is about you or your damn insecurities. Maybe I just need a break from all of this." "All of what?" Hudson asked, his voice quieter, though his chest was tight. "From me? From our marriage?" Camila didn't answer right away. She just stared at him, her expression unreadable. Then she shook her head, grabbed her purse from the chair, and walked toward the door. "I'm leaving tomorrow morning, and I don't want to talk about this anymore. I'm tired, Hudson. I'm tired of this." He watched as she disappeared into the hallway, her footsteps fading up the stairs. He stood there, alone in the kitchen, the wine glass still half full on the table. His eyes flicked to her phone, still face down, and the urge to pick it up to see who had texted her, nod at him. But he didn't move. He couldn't bring himself to cross that line. Not yet. The next morning, Hudson stood by the window, watching as Camila loaded her bags into the car. She hadn't said much to him when she woke up, just a mumbled goodbye as she packed. She was efficient, almost mechanical, as if she had done this 100 times before. She slammed the trunk shut and walked around to the driver's side. Hudson watched her hesitate for a second, her hand on the door handle. She glanced up at the house, but her eyes didn't meet his through the window. She opened the door, got in, and drove off without looking back. Hudson stood there, feeling a cold weight settle in his chest. He wanted to believe her. He wanted to believe that it was just a weekend trip with her friend. But as her car disappeared down the road, a sinking feeling grew in his gut. Something wasn't right. And deep down, he knew it had been wrong for a long time. He just didn't know how bad it was yet. But he was about to find out. The house was quiet, the kind of silence that feels uncomfortable, like it's hiding something. Hudson sat at the kitchen table, staring at his coffee cup, his mind wandering. Camila was away for the weekend, supposedly at the lake with her friends. And Riley, their 18-year-old daughter, was upstairs in her room. But even the peace of a Saturday morning didn't settle him. For weeks, there had been a tension growing inside him, something he couldn't shake. Camila had been acting distant. Even Riley, who used to chat with him every morning over breakfast, had pulled away. He barely saw her anymore, except when she came downstairs to grab a snack or disappear out the front door without a word. He was lost in thought when his phone buzzed on the table. He glanced at the screen, an unknown number flashing. He almost ignored it, but something made him pick it up. Maybe it was that gnawing feeling in his gut, the one that had been bothering him for months. The message was short but devastating. "You need to know what your wife is really up to. She's with a guy right now. Here's the address. Come see for yourself." Hudson stared at the screen, his heart thudding in his chest. His hand shook as he gripped the phone tighter. He read the message again, trying to make sense of it. His mind raced, flipping between disbelief and the creeping suspicion that had been haunting him. He stood abruptly, knocking his chair back. Riley's door creaked open upstairs, and her voice called out, "Dad? Everything okay?" "Yeah," Hudson replied, his voice strained. "Just going out for a bit." He didn't wait for a response, already halfway out the door. The address from the message was miles outside of town, in a part of the city Hudson rarely visited. The drive felt endless, each mile stretching his nerves tighter. His hands gripped the steering wheel, his knuckles white, his mind swirling with worst-case scenarios. It couldn't be true. This was some kind of mistake. Maybe it was a prank, someone trying to mess with him. But deep down, he knew something was wrong. When he finally pulled up to the address, his stomach dropped. It was a rundown motel, the kind where no one asks questions, the kind where secrets are buried. He parked across the street, far enough that he wouldn't be seen, but close enough to get a clear view. His heart pounded in his chest as he scanned the parking lot, his eyes darting between the rows of cars. He didn't know what he was expecting to see, but then he saw her. Camila. She stepped out of a motel room, laughing, her head thrown back as she leaned against a man Hudson didn't recognize. They were close, too close. She was touching his arm, and then he kissed her right there in the open like it was the most natural thing in the world. Rage and devastation flooded Hudson in equal measure. His hands trembled as he gripped the steering wheel, staring in disbelief. Camila, the woman he had built a life with, the mother of his daughter, was standing there, in the arms of another man. He wanted to get out of the car. He wanted to scream, to confront them right then and there. But he couldn't move. His chest tightened, the betrayal crushing him. He had suspected something, but seeing it with his own eyes made it real. Camila and the man eventually walked back into the motel room, the door closing behind them, leaving Hudson sitting in his car, stunned and shaking. His mind raced. Was this the first time? How long had it been going on? He felt like his entire world had just been ripped apart, everything he thought he knew about his life now a lie. Later that evening, back at the house, Hudson sat on the edge of the bed, his head in his hands. Camila wasn't due back until the next day, but he couldn't wait. He had to confront her. He had to know why. The front door creaked open around midnight. Hudson listened as Camila moved through the hallway, her footsteps light, almost carefree. The sound made his blood boil. He waited until she came into the bedroom. "Hey, you're still up?" she asked casually, dropping her bag on the floor. She didn't notice the tension in the room, the way Hudson was staring at her like she was a stranger. He didn't respond right away. He just watched her as she moved toward the closet, pulling out a t-shirt and shorts to change into. "Where were you really?" he asked, his voice low but steady. Camila froze for a split second, then turned around, a smile plastered on her face. "What do you mean?" "I told you. I was with my friends at the lake. Don't lie to me." Hudson stood up now, his fists clenched at his sides. "I know you weren't with them." Camila's smile faltered, but she quickly recovered. "Hudson, what are you talking about?" "Of course I was. You're being paranoid again. I saw you, Camila. I saw you with him." Her face went pale for a second, but then her expression shifted. She rolled her eyes and crossed her arms. "It wasn't what it looked like." Hudson felt the anger surge inside him. "It wasn't what it looked like? I watched you kiss him, Camila. How is that not what it looks like?" "It was a mistake," she said, her voice cold, almost dismissive. "An accident." "An accident?" Hudson's voice rose, disbelief washing over him. "I caught you in our bed, Camila. How is that an accident?" Camila didn't flinch. "Look, I'm sorry, okay? But it didn't mean anything." Hudson shook his head, his mind reeling. "You're unbelievable. Do you think that makes it better? That it didn't mean anything?" Before Camila could respond, Riley's door opened down the hall. Their daughter appeared in the doorway, her eyes half closed with sleep, but quickly snapping awake when she saw the scene unfolding. "What's going on?" Riley asked, her voice thick with confusion. "Your mother has something she needs to explain," Hudson said, his eyes never leaving Camila. But before Camila could say anything, Riley stepped forward, arms crossed defensively. "Dad, just drop it. It's not that big of a deal." Hudson's heart sank as he turned to his daughter. "Not a big deal? Riley, your mother, I know," Riley snapped, cutting him off. "I knew about it, okay? Mom told me everything." Hudson's stomach twisted. "You knew?" Riley shrugged, her face set in a defiant scowl. "Yeah, I knew all the time, and I don't care. It's not worth blowing up our family over some stupid mistake." Hudson couldn't believe what he was hearing. His daughter, his own daughter, was defending Camila, defending her betrayal. "How could you side with her on this?" "Because she's my mom, and you're overreacting," Riley shouted back, her voice breaking. "Dad, if you leave us over something as stupid as Mom's accidental affair, then you're dead to me. You can't forgive Mom for a mistake. Just go." Hudson stood there, frozen. He stared at Riley, trying to process what she had just said. His daughter, his wife, both of them, standing there, as if his entire world wasn't collapsing around him. The betrayal wasn't just Camila's anymore. It was Riley's too. He didn't say another word. There was nothing left to say. The woman he loved, the daughter he had raised, they had both chosen their sides. And he wasn't part of it. Without a word, Hudson turned and walked down the hallway. He grabbed a suitcase from the closet, stuffed in a few clothes, and left the house. He drove away, leaving everything behind. Leaving them behind. Hudson stared out the window of his new apartment, watching the rain trickle down the glass. It had been a year since he left. The pain still came in waves, but the intensity had dulled, replaced by a quiet contentment he hadn't expected. He had vanished without a trace, left everything behind, and started a new life. The first few months had been unbearable. He thought about Camila and Riley constantly, wondering what they were doing, if they missed him, if they even cared that he was gone. But as time passed, the pain turned into something different. It turned into resolve. He knew he had made the right choice. He had to leave. Staying would have destroyed him. Hudson moved to a different state, somewhere no one knew him. He rented a small apartment, got a job at a local construction company, and kept his head down. He had no interest in making friends, no desire to talk about the past. His life before Camila, Riley, the betrayal felt like a distant dream, something that happened to someone else. But as the months rolled by, something unexpected happened. He began to thrive. Hudson sat at a local cafe, sipping his coffee as he reviewed blueprints for a new project. The construction company he started working for had quickly noticed his skills, and he rose through the ranks. A year in, he was managing projects, his attention to detail and work ethics setting him apart from the rest. He had thrown himself into his work, using it as a distraction from the chaos of his old life. But it had become more than that. He realized he was good at it, really good. For the first time in years, he felt capable, in control of his future. It was something he hadn't felt in a long time. The work kept him busy, kept his mind off the past. Slowly, he started rebuilding his life, brick by brick. He saved enough money to open his own construction business, a small one at first. But word spread quickly about the quality of his work. Jobs came in faster than he could handle, and before long, he was hiring a crew. It wasn't just his professional life that had changed. As Hudson built his business, he also rebuilt himself. He joined a gym, something he hadn't done in years, and worked out daily. The physical activity helped clear his mind, made him feel stronger, more alive. And then there was the dating. He hadn't planned on it. He didn't think he'd be ready for another relationship for a long time, if ever. But life had a way of surprising him. It started small, a casual conversation with a woman who owned the cafe he frequented. Her name was Mila, and she was kind, easy to talk to. They laughed about small things, exchanged stories about their day. It was nothing serious at first, just friendly banter. But slowly, over time, the conversations became longer, the laughs deeper. One evening, as Hudson was about to leave, Mila asked him if he wanted to stay after closing and share a bottle of wine. He hesitated for a moment, then nodded. They sat by the window, the cafe dark and quiet, the wine flowing freely between them. Mila was different from Camila in every way. Where Camila had been sharp, always pushing for more, Mila was soft, patient. She listened when Hudson talked, really listened. It wasn't long before they started dating, though Hudson was careful to keep things slow. He didn't want to rush into anything. He wasn't sure he could trust anyone again. But Mila didn't push. She let him take his time. And eventually, Hudson realized that not every relationship had to end in betrayal. Not every woman was Camila. Meanwhile, Camila's life was unraveling. Back home, in the house Hudson had left behind, things had fallen apart quickly. At first, Camila thought she could manage. After all, she still had her job, the house, and Riley. But nothing was the same. The affair partner, Austin, who had once seemed like a thrilling escape, lost interest after Hudson's departure. He faded from her life as quickly as he had entered it, leaving Camila alone in the wreckage of her choices. The bills piled up, and without Hudson's steady income, it became harder to keep up. She had to sell the house, moving into a smaller apartment with Riley. The financial strain was only part of the problem. The emotional toll of Hudson's departure weighed heavily on them both. Riley, once a bright, promising student, began to struggle in school. The cracks in her parents' marriage had deeply affected her, and Hudson's disappearance left her angry and confused. She lashed out at Camila, blaming her for everything. Their relationship, once close, became strained. Riley withdrew, spending more time with friends who were bad influences, and her grades plummeted. Camila tried to reach out to her daughter, tried to repair the damage, but it was too late. The guilt of her affair and the loss of Hudson consumed her. She had thought leaving Hudson would free her, but instead, it trapped her in a life of regret and isolation. Hudson never looked back. He didn't check on Camila or Riley. He didn't ask about them or try to find out how they were doing. It was easier to let them go completely, to cut all ties. His new life was separate, clean, untainted by the past. But every once in a while, late at night, he thought about them. He wondered if they were okay, if Riley had graduated, if Camila regretted what she had done. Those thoughts came less and less frequently as the years went by, but they never fully disappeared. 5 years passed like this, quietly, peacefully. Hudson built a successful business, found a new relationship, and most importantly, he found peace. The man who had been shattered by betrayal was gone. In his place stood someone stronger, someone who had learned to thrive on his own. But even though Hudson had moved on, the past wasn't finished with him yet. The knock at the door was unexpected, breaking the quiet evening Hudson had grown accustomed to in his new life. He had just finished dinner and was settling down with a book when the sound startled him. His first instinct was to ignore it. He wasn't expecting anyone, and visitors were rare. But something about the knock made him pause. Reluctantly, he stood up, walked to the door, and pulled it open. Standing there, shivering in the cold autumn air, was Riley. She looked different from the last time he had seen her 5 years ago. Her hair was longer, and her face had matured, but her eyes, those familiar eyes, were red from crying, and her cheeks were streaked with tears. "Daddy," she whispered, her voice barely audible, cracking under the weight of her emotions. "I need your help." Hudson froze, his hand still on the door handle. The word "daddy" hit him like a punch to the gut. He hadn't heard it in years, not since the night he left. Hearing it again now, from the same daughter who had told him he was dead to her, felt like reopening a wound he thought had long healed. "I can't pay for college," Riley continued, her voice trembling. "Everything's falling apart. Mom can't help, and I don't know what else to do. Please, will you help me?" Hudson stared at her, his face unreadable. He had imagined this moment so many times over the years, what he would say, how he would react if Riley or Camila ever came back. But now that it was happening, the emotions were too complex to untangle. Anger, hurt, betrayal, and something else, something softer, mixed in his chest. But he kept his expression cold. For a long moment, he didn't say anything. He just stood there, staring at her. This was the same girl who had screamed at him, who had chosen her mother over him without hesitation, who had defended Camila's betrayal without a second thought. And now, she was standing in front of him, asking for help. Hudson took a slow breath, steadying himself. He turned away from her without a word, walking to the kitchen counter. There, sitting quietly amidst the clutter of everyday life, was a manila envelope. He had kept it for years, knowing this day might come, though he hadn't been sure if he would ever use it. He picked it up, the weight of it heavy in his hand, and returned to the door. Riley was still standing there, her eyes pleading, her face pale with worry. Without a word, Hudson handed her the envelope. She looked at it, confused, her hands shaking as she took it from him. What is this?" she asked, her voice barely above a whisper. "Open it," Hudson said, his voice flat, emotionless. Riley hesitated, her fingers fumbling with the clasp before she finally pulled out the contents. She unfolded the papers inside, her eyes scanning the words. As the realization hit, her face drained of all color. "These are DNA results?" she asked, her voice shaking. "Yes," Hudson said, his tone as cold as the autumn wind. "I had them done a few years ago, after I left. I needed to know the truth." Riley's hands trembled as she read the results. "What does this mean? Why would you?" Hudson cut her off, his eyes hard. "You're not my daughter, Riley. You never were." Riley staggered back, as if the words had physically struck her. "No, no, that can't be true," she stammered, tears spilling down her cheeks. "You're my dad. You've always been my dad." "Not anymore," Hudson said, his voice breaking just slightly before he steeled himself again. "I raised you. I loved you. But it was all based on a lie. Your mother's lie." Riley shook her head, tears falling faster now. "Dad, please. I didn't know. I didn't know any of this." "You can't just—" "I can," Hudson interrupted, his eyes narrowing. "And I am. Go ask your real father for the money, Riley. The man your mother slept with accidentally. Maybe he can afford to give you away. I'm not funding anything for a stranger. You're nothing to Mui." Riley gasped, clutching the papers tighter, her eyes wide with disbelief. "What are you talking about? You're my dad. How can you just throw me away like this?" Hudson's jaw tightened. "Throw you away? You and your mother threw me away the night I left. You made your choice. You told me I was dead to you. Remember that?" Riley's face crumpled, fresh tears pouring down. "I was angry. I didn't understand. I was just a kid. You were old enough to know better," Hudson snapped, cutting her off again. "You chose her. You defended her after everything she did. You knew about the affair, and you didn't care. And now, you expect me to help you? After all of that?" Riley opened her mouth to speak, but found no words. She looked down at the DNA results again, as if hoping they would somehow change if she stared at them long enough. But the truth was inescapable. The man she had always called Dad wasn't her father, and the man her mother had chosen over him was nowhere to be found. I didn't know, she whispered, her voice barely audible. I didn't know you weren't. I didn't know it would end like this. Hudson's heart twisted, but he refused to let himself soften. Not now. Not after everything. It's too late for apologies, Riley. I gave you everything, and you threw it away. Riley's sobs grew louder, her whole body shaking. Please, please don't do this. I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know it would hurt you like this. Hudson closed his eyes, fighting against the wave of emotions crashing over him. For a moment, he wanted to reach out, to pull her into his arms like he used to when she was little and scared. But the pain, the betrayal, it was too deep. I can't help you, Hudson said finally, his voice cold and final. You're not my responsibility anymore. Riley's face crumpled as she backed away, clutching the envelope to her chest. Her eyes were wide with desperation, but she could see that Hudson's mind was made up. Please, she whispered one last time, her voice breaking. But Hudson just shook his head. Goodbye, Riley. Riley stumbled backward, turning and running down the steps of his porch, her sobs echoing in the night. Hudson watched her go, his heart heavy but resolute. He closed the door and leaned against it, letting out a long, shaky breath. The weight of everything settled on him, but he knew it had to be done. She had made her choice, and now she had to live with it. Just like he had. Weeks passed. The knock came again, soft, tentative, as though whoever was on the other side was afraid of what waited. Hudson hesitated, the memory of Riley's tear-streaked face from a few weeks earlier flashing through his mind. His life had been quiet, peaceful, since that night. He didn't want to disturb it, but something gnawed at him, something that told him he needed to face whoever was there. When he opened the door, he wasn't surprised to see Camila. But the woman standing in front of him now was a far cry from the confident, dismissive wife who had once scoffed at his pain. Camila was gaunt, her hair unkempt, and her eyes hollow, framed by deep lines that spoke of sleepless nights and endless regret. Her clothes hung loosely on her, as if they belonged to someone else, someone who still had a sense of dignity. Hudson, she whispered, her voice shaking, please, I'm begging you. Hudson's face remained impassive, his eyes scanning her face without a flicker of emotion. He leaned against the doorframe, arms crossed, waiting for her to continue. I made a mistake, Camila said, her voice cracking as she spoke. I was stupid. I ruined everything. I ruined us. Her hands were shaking, and she wrung them together as if trying to hold on to something, anything, to keep herself from falling apart completely. Tears welled up in her eyes, but Hudson remained silent. He had nothing to say. There was nothing left between them. Hudson, please, she choked out, her voice trembling as she reached toward him. I lost everything. Austin, he left me. He's gone. And Riley. She's all I have left, but even she's slipping away from me. At the mention of Riley, Hudson's expression hardened. You lost her the moment you chose to destroy our family, he said coldly. Don't put that on me. Camila's knees buckled, and she collapsed onto the porch, her sobs racking her frail body. She looked up at him, her face streaked with tears, desperation etched into every line. Please, Hudson, I'll do anything. I'll spend the rest of my life making it up to you. I'll change. I've changed. Just forgive me. Please. For a long moment, Hudson didn't respond. He just looked down at her, at the woman he had once loved, now reduced to this broken, pleading figure. He remembered the Camila who used to laugh with him, who had promised him forever. But that woman had died the night she betrayed him. All that was left was this ghost of her, begging for something she had no right to ask for. Forgive you? Hudson's voice was calm, steady, but there was a coldness in his tone that cut through the air like a blade. You think I can just forget everything you did? You think a few words and tears can erase years of betrayal? Camila flinched at his words, but she didn't stop pleading. I know I was wrong, Hudson. I know I hurt you, hurt Riley. But I'm a different person now. I've learned from my mistakes. I just need a second chance. Hudson shook his head slowly, his eyes narrowing as he looked down at her. A second chance? You already had that chance, Camila. You had 10 years of chances to be honest, to be faithful, to care about our family. But you threw all of that away. You chose him. You chose to betray me and then had the nerve to lie about it. I was scared. Camila cried, her voice rising with desperation. I didn't know how to fix things. I didn't know what to do. I was weak. You were selfish, Hudson cut in sharply. Don't twist this into some excuse about being scared or weak. You made a choice, Camila. You chose to destroy our marriage, our family, because you wanted something else. You chose him. Camila's sobs grew louder, her body trembling as she knelt before him. I was wrong. I know that now. I swear, if I could go back, I'd do everything differently. I'd be the wife you deserved. I would. Hudson's laugh cut her off, bitter and cold. The wife I deserved? You have no idea what I deserve, Camila. You never did. She looked up at him, her eyes wide, pleading. Hudson, please. I can't go on like this. I've lost everything. Don't leave me like this. Don't let me live with this guilt for the rest of my life. Hudson stared at her for a long moment, his expression unreadable. He could see how far she had fallen, how much her life had crumbled since he had left. But none of that moved him. The years of pain, of betrayal, had hardened his heart in a way that no amount of begging could undo. You want me to forgive you to ease your guilt? Hudson asked quietly. You want me to take you back so you can feel better about what you did? Camila shook her head frantically. No, it's not like that, isn't it? Hudson stepped closer, his voice low and cold. You're not here because you love me. You're here because you can't stand the weight of your own mistakes. You want me to take that burden off of you, to absolve you, so you don't have to feel this pain anymore. Camila sobbed harder, but she couldn't argue with him. She had no defense left. I'm sorry, she whispered. I'm so sorry. Sorry doesn't change what you did, Hudson said, his voice growing firmer. You destroyed us, Camila. You destroyed our family. And now you want me to forgive you, so you can sleep at night? So you don't have to carry the consequences of your actions. Camila's head dropped, her body shaking as she wept uncontrollably. She had nothing left to say. She had begged. She had pleaded. But there was no undoing what she had done. Hudson took a step back, his face hardening as he looked down at her. You and I are finished, Camila. There's no going back. Not after everything. You made your choices, and now you have to live with them. Camila lifted her head, her eyes wide with fear. Please, Hudson, don't leave me like this. Don't turn your back on me. I already did, Hudson said quietly, his voice carrying the finality of a tombstone. Years ago, I left you behind when you left me behind, and I haven't looked back since. He turned, stepping inside his home, his hand on the door as he gave her one last look. The woman on his porch, broken and pleading, was nothing more than a stranger to him now. Goodbye, Camila, he said softly, closing the door behind him. Camila remained on the porch for a long time after that, her sobs echoing in the night, unheard by the man she had once called her husband. The years passed, and Hudson's life slowly began to rebuild itself from the ashes of his past. Camila and Riley became distant memories, the pain they had caused gradually fading into the background. The small town he had moved to embraced him, and in its quiet streets and friendly faces, Hudson found a semblance of peace. One crisp autumn day, Hudson was at a local cafe, enjoying his usual cup of coffee, when he noticed a woman sitting at a nearby table. She had a warm smile and an air of quiet confidence. Her name was Mila, a recent transplant to the town, and as fate would have it, she struck up a conversation with Hudson. "Do you come here often?" Mila asked, her eyes sparkling with genuine curiosity. Almost every morning, Hudson replied, returning her smile. It's my little ritual. Over the next few weeks, their casual conversations turned into something deeper. Mila was kind, understanding, and most importantly, she valued the things Hudson had once taken for granted, loyalty, trust, and love. It was a stark contrast to the betrayal he had endured, and he found himself drawn to her more and more each day. One evening, as they walked through the park, the leaves crunching beneath their feet, Mila turned to Hudson with a thoughtful expression. You've been through a lot, haven't you? Hudson nodded, the weight of his past still lingering but no longer suffocating. I have, but meeting you has been like a breath of fresh air. Mila took his hand in hers, squeezing it gently. You deserve happiness, Hudson. We all do. Their relationship blossomed, built on the foundation of mutual respect and shared values. Mila became the anchor Hudson needed, helping him to finally let go of the remnants of his old life. They married in a small ceremony, surrounded by new friends who had become like family. Mila's support and unwavering love allowed Hudson to heal fully. They bought a house together, a charming place with a garden that Mila adored. They spent weekends planting flowers, laughing, and enjoying the simple pleasures of life that Hudson had missed for so long. One day, as they sat on their porch, watching the sunset, Mila rested her head on Hudson's shoulder. "I'm so grateful for you," she said softly. "I can't imagine my life without you." Hudson kissed her forehead, feeling a warmth he had thought lost forever. "I feel the same way. You've given me a second chance at happiness." As the years went by, Hudson and Mila's life was filled with joy. They traveled, explored new hobbies, and cherished every moment together. The memories of Camila and Riley became mere shadows, distant and insignificant against the bright light of the life Hudson had built. Meanwhile, Camila and her lover continued to spiral into regret and suffering. The financial ruin and broken relationships that followed their betrayal were harsh reminders of the consequences of their actions. Riley, struggling to find her own way, often thought back to the father she had once dismissed so easily, realizing too late the value of what she had lost. One day, Hudson received a letter in the mail. It was from Riley, filled with apologies and pleas for reconciliation. She wrote about her struggles, her regrets, and the pain of losing him. Hudson read the letter carefully, his heart heavy with a mix of emotions. Mila found him sitting at the kitchen table, the letter in his hands. "What's wrong?" she asked, concern etched on her face. "It's from Riley," Hudson said quietly. "She wants to make amends." Mila sat beside him, placing a comforting hand on his arm. "What do you want to do?" Hudson sighed, looking out the window at the life he had built. "I think it's time to let go completely. I've moved on, and I can't go back to that pain. I need to focus on the present and the future we have together." Mila nodded, understanding his decision. "Whatever you choose, I'll support you." With Mila's encouragement, Hudson decided to write back, wishing Riley well, but making it clear that his new life didn't have room for the past. It was a final step in his journey of healing, closing the chapter on that painful part of his life for good. As the seasons changed, Hudson and Mila continued to thrive. They embraced each day with gratitude, knowing that the love and trust they shared were the true foundations of their happiness. And in the end, Hudson realized that sometimes the greatest revenge wasn't in causing suffering to those who wronged you, but in finding the strength to move on and live a life filled with love and peace. Years had passed, and Hudson's life had settled into a peaceful routine. Every morning, he'd wake up to the scent of freshly brewed coffee, Mila humming softly as she prepared breakfast. Their home was filled with warmth and laughter, a stark contrast to the emptiness he had once felt. One crisp afternoon, as Hudson was working in the garden, Mila came out with the newspaper. "You're not going to believe this," she said, sitting down beside him on the porch steps. Hudson glanced up from the flower bed, wiping dirt from his hands. "What is it?" She handed him the paper, her face a mixture of sympathy and quiet satisfaction. The headline read, "Local woman files for bankruptcy after years of financial hardship." Hudson's eyes skimmed over the article. It detailed Camila's financial collapse, how she had lost her job, how the debts had piled up, and how her once proud life had crumbled into ruin. The man she had risked everything for was long gone, leaving her to bear the weight of her choices alone. Mila watched him closely, gauging his reaction. "How does it feel?" she asked softly. Hudson stared at the article for a long moment, then set it aside with a sigh. "Honestly, it feels like justice, but I don't feel the way I thought I would." Mila nodded, understanding. "It's because you've moved on, Hudson. You're not that man anymore." He smiled at her, appreciating her insight. "I guess I'm not." Despite the fleeting satisfaction of seeing Camila's downfall, Hudson didn't dwell on it. His heart no longer carried the bitterness it once had. Over the years, he had learned that true revenge wasn't about watching someone else suffer. It was about finding peace and happiness in your own life. And that was something Camila and Riley could never take away from him. Occasionally, whispers would reach him about Riley too. She had dropped out of college, her life derailed by the same poor decisions that had wrecked her mother's. People in town spoke of her wandering from job to job, struggling to find stability. There were even rumors that she had tried to reach out to Hudson again, but he had made his decision long ago. He had given her the opportunity for a relationship, and she had thrown it away. He wasn't going to reopen those wounds. One evening, as Hudson and Mila sat together by the fireplace, she gently touched his hand. "Do you ever think about them? Camila, Riley, everything that happened?" Hudson paused, considering the question. "I think about the lessons more than the people," he said thoughtfully. "What it taught me about trust, about loyalty. But as for Camila and Riley themselves? Not really. They made their choices." Mila rested her head on his shoulder. "You've built something so much better now. I'm glad you didn't let it destroy you." "I am too," Hudson agreed, feeling the warmth of the fire and Mila's presence beside him. "I could have gone down the same path, let the anger consume me. But walking away, that was the best decision I ever made." Mila smiled, kissing his cheek. "I'm glad you did too, because it led you here." The days of betrayal felt like another lifetime, distant and unimportant. Camila and Riley were mere ghosts of his past. And as he sat there, basking in the peace of his present, Hudson knew he had truly won. He had survived the storm, found the strength to rebuild, and in doing so, had created a life filled with love, trust, and happiness. Years later, whenever someone would bring up Camila or Riley in passing conversation, Hudson would simply smile and change the subject. Their struggles, their regret, those were their burdens to bear. He had no interest in their downfall. He had already found his victory, and it wasn't in their suffering. It was in the life he had built, the happiness he had found, and the love that surrounded him. In the end, the cost of betrayal had been steep for them. But for Hudson, the future was bright, a testament to his resilience and the peace he had earned after the storm. And that, as he quietly reflected while holding Mila's hand, was the greatest victory of all.